Shalom to everybody. Can you have an idea of my feeling right now to see you? Huh? I will start to tell you a little bit by myself. I grew up in Yerushalayim. I'm in sixth generation born in Jerusalem. I live in Mea Shearim, the most religious part, strong religious. My father was a big, big tzaddik, big rabbi. He make 18 books of the law from Judaism. Living in very small apartment, 70 meters, 10 kids. In the 50s, arrived to Israel new immigrants from Yemen. The government sent all Yemenis to Rosh Ain. Rosh Ain is a city near Petah Tikva, special city for the Yemenis. In this time, in 53, 54, Israel has not money to build homes, they build tents. These people, the new immigrants, they live in tents, many kids, winter, blotte, I don't want to say blotte in English, you understand what I mean? Huh? Night. My father, Zecher Tzadik Livracha, takes a little truck, a little car, goes to Rosh Ain, and take a microphone and says, people, if you have not a place for your children right away, I have a place in Yerushalayim. You understand? In this 70 meter with 10 kids, there's a place. And he brought in 5 kids, Yemeni kids. I used to sleep in my bed with 2 Yemenis. When my father passed away 7 years ago, the Prime Minister Bibi and F from the government come to my home, to me at Foshive. They come in, they see the room, they see the apartment. I tell them the story, tell this is my bed is still there. But they want to say, here I sleep with 2 Yemenis. And this, I finish only to speak, one from the boys that sleep with me together, Rafael, he comes in the room to the shiva, and he started to cry, this is my room, this is my bed, this is how you sleep here. They see this life, what I say. After the 6-day war, everybody knows that the 6-day war, before the war, everybody thinks that Israel is destroyed complete. Because the all Arab nations attacked in one time Israel. Egypt, Syria, Iraq, Lebanon, Jordan, everybody in one time attacked Israel. And none of you know, the Prime Minister was in this time Levi Eshkol. He gives a speech to give a coachment and he started to shaking in the middle of the speech. And God make a miracle. 6 days, Israel succeeds. They come in close to Cairo, close to Damascus, close to in Lebanon. They come to Jordan. They take back Yerushalayim. And the 4th day that we coming to the Western Wall, to the Kotel in Yerushalayim, I was there. I stay and I say, what can I give back a gift to God? A present for God, for the miracles that only 7 days ago everybody left Israel. Everybody that has a passport left Israel. Everybody thinks finished. After 6 days, a miracle like this, I say the best gift that I can give God back is to care for his children. Because the most happy that you can do for a father when you love his children, you're caring. I don't know if you know, in many sidurim, you're praying in the morning, they said, before you praying, say, I take of myself the mitzvah to love my brother like I love myself. Vo'av tov le'reicha kamocha. Love your brother like you love yourself. This is written in the sidurim, and did what you need to say before davening. One time was a child, later he became a big rabbi, and he asked his father, Father, what connection is love your brother like you love yourself with praying? If you go to pray, you ask for health, for success, what connection? In the Torah you have also that you say every day, Vo'avto et Hashem Elokecha. Love God. The Torah says that you need to love God. The boy says to his father, I think will be a big meaning, more meaning, if before you go to pray, you say, God, I love you. And then you go to pray. What connection has with your brother? The father answered him, you, because you don't marry, you have no children, your question is right. But the time will come, then when you will have children, you will be a father, and the children will ask, what is more important, love the father, or the father want to see that the children loves one the other? You will say, mine proud, mine happy to see my children, they love one the other. This is the connection. You go to speak to Hashem, the Hashem is the father, from Am Yisrael, the Torah says, Banim atem l'Hashem Elokechem. Every Jew is like a child. If you go to pray, you ask for health, you ask for success, you ask for children, and before them you say, God, I promise you, I will love my brother like I love myself, then you're sure that your praying will be received. This, I think, when I stay by the Kotel, and I say, I must to leave Yerushalayim. They have many beards and payers there, mit schwarze Kapeluchen, you know. I will go to a place, they need me, that nobody is there. Migdal HaEmek, in this time, was the worst place in Israel. Crime, drugs, like Harlem in New York. I can't explain you right now why, but this is the fact. Every day in paper, they blew up the city, they killed. I decided to go to Migdal HaEmek. I come to Migdal HaEmek, I was naive, you know, I come from Mea Shearim. First question what I ask, who is the yeshiva? What yeshiva? I ask, who is the Talmud Torah? Or Talmud Torah? Who can I find the youngsters? Because I have a special feeling for the youngsters. They say, in the disco. Disco? I never hear disco in my life. In Mea Shearim, you don't know what means disco. I come to the disco. First time, I think maybe there's a yeshiva called disco. I go to the disco and I see, you know, dancing and fight. But they look in me, they come in, a rabbi with a board in payers. They thinking, maybe somebody died outside. I look for a minion, for Kaddish. What you doing here? I say, I came here, I want to leave you. You want to leave you? You crazy? Everybody thinks to go to Yerushalayim. You come here, I say, yes, you're my brother. If you live here, I also can live here. And I decided to give my life for these boys and girls. And it started in something like a magnet comes. They became very close to me. Then my home became the disco. They started to come to me with help, with this, dancing. I used to go every night to the disco. And it's not so bad, you say, huh? The disco is only the place because they don't go to the school, not to the, any place. This was the place there. And then somebody tell me that they have a big problem there. what happened? Many girls, maybe it's ashamed to say in the front from everybody, many girls, because they pull, they sell themselves for the Arabs near Migdal HaEmek, is Nazareth. It was very bad situation. I say, who is the organized that may organize something like this? I can't believe that can be. Because I see they show me the place, come cows from Nazareth, from the place. They say somebody the name Pinchas. Pinchas is the man that he organized. Pinchas, who is Pinchas? Pinchas is like El Capuna, you know El Capuna? He was the worst gangster. The police is afraid for Pinchas. I decided to go to Pinchas. I go to his home. Till today, I remember the neighbor downstairs, Ashkenazi from Romania, says, the Rebbe gets to them Goslin. The rabbi is going to the murder, you know, to the thief. I come in, I knock in the door, Pinchas open up the door, he says, what you looking? I say, what I looking? I want to drink with you L'chaim. You're looking, you're crazy. Yes, let me go in. Pinchas, why are you doing this? This is my job, I make money. Pinchas, I will do for you. I will go to the factories and find a job. I will work in a factory. I stay up 7 o'clock in the morning, 6 o'clock. If somebody tell me what to do, I kill him. Tell me, Pinchas, what you like to do? Give me your dream. He says, if I will have a truck myself, I can stay up when I want, and I will deliver it with my drug, with my trucks, people, something, this will me, I make money, this make me happy. I don't know why I tell you this. I go back, I have a home in Yerushalayim, sell the home, take the money, and I buy a truck. I come to Pinchas, and I say, here you have the keys, you have a truck. Was a big factory in Migdal HaEmek called Beget O, very famous for women's clothing, Reklach, you know. They sent us every day to airport, to Europe, to Germany, to many places. I go to the manager, I say, here is a man, he has a truck, you will give him the job. From this minute, Pinchas changed himself not to believe. He started to clean the old city from the old crime. No Arabs can go in. They have afraid till today to go in Migdal HaEmek from the Pinchas. He changed himself complete. Was that they make a television of me in 1970. The television, the headline was Disco Rabbi. And Pinchas speaks in this television. He don't shame to say. You say, I was like this and I do this. And when I see that somebody that don't know me, any connection, a rabbi, comes and give me a talk and trust me and believe in me, I decided I will change myself. And it became a Baal Tshuva. It became back to Yiddishkeit. This is show you that if you try, can be the worst, but he has a neshome. He has a neshome. Every Jew has a soul inside. You need only to come to speak to him. Then somebody tell me my brother is in jail. I say to him, your brother is my brother. I come to the jail. First time in my life, Shata, Jewish boys, Moshe, Yaakov, Yitzchak, I can't believe. I go to the head from the jail and I say, I want to make a program here. I want to come twice a week to learning Pirkei Avot with the prisoners. Remember, Pirkei Avot is very interesting because Pirkei Avot is not only religious. Pirkei Avot is like psychiatrists, a psychologue. They teach you how to behave. I started with Pirkei Avot. little by little, we built a program that the government says that is the most success program till today, more than 40 years, 80% don't go back to jail. Right now, when I sit with you here, we have in the old prisons in Israel, more than 1,000 prisoners in this program. More than 1,000 prisoners. 80% don't go back to jail. And what is the secret? What is the, they ask me, what is the secret? Sometime we have a big convention. They say the government, they put in psychologen, criminologen, sociologen, cocologen, what you want, everybody, and don't walk. And you come and they started Pirkei Avos and they started feeling and they learning and they change. What is the secret? The secret is that the power from belief, this is the biggest power that you can have. There was a story, there was very holy rabbi from Baal Shem Tov's students, the name the Bardichevarov, maybe you hear the Bardichevarov, was something special. The Bardichevarov, sometime Pesach night, the Seder, he asked his gabbai, his manager, I want that you will brought me right now a piece of bread. You, Pesach night, a piece of bread? The gabbai thinks, who can I find a piece of bread? He decided what somebody there was very, he be called the worst man there, crime man. Very, he says, maybe this man has the bread. He comes over to this man, he says, he knocks in the door. He says, comes, what you looking? Maybe you left over bread? Bread in Pesach? 3 months my wife is cleaning the home, make me crazy. And you looking for bread? You give him 2 patch, you know, give him and send them back. He's come to the rabbi, I became a fly, but not bread. 2 minutes later, the rabbi says, I wanted to brought me a little drugs, you know, hashish, I don't know how to call those, hashish is small, a little from the drugs, the strong drugs. I don't know what the rabbi want from him tonight. Okay, you think, who can I find drugs for the rabbi? He's going back to the same man. He knocks in the door, the man open up the door, I tell you that I have not bread. No bread. What you looking? I looking, you know. the drug. Ah, this? Okay, wait. 2 minutes later, he give him a person from the drugs. He brought us to the rabbi. The rabbi goes into the synagogue with the drugs. He says, Rabbeinu Shalom, God, look. Not to have bread, Pesach, you have not any policemen, any punishment, any jails. I can't find a piece of bread. This that I have in my hand, how much policemen looking for them? How much punishment? 2 minutes I find this. What is the answer? Believe. If you, why you have not bread Pesach? Because you believe in the Torah. You believe that you're Jew, you keep up Pesach. This is the answer. The guys in the jails, of course, the most secret is that you give them love. They feel that you are brother. You want to help them. It's an old system, not the time to, I will give you only an example. Think that somebody, a rabbi, come to the home from this prisoner, knock in the door, and say, you know, your husband in jail receive a special prize because he learns, he became very good, what you call, in the exam. Oh, somebody thinks of him. You come home to the prison's home, you speak to his children. They need a bar mitzvah, they need a chasene. He feels that you don't only come and teach him. You like a brother. This change, Baruch Hashem, hundreds come back and they don't go to jail more. And this is only because you give him love and you give him belief. And they understand that you love him. Because I want to tell you, my friends, you say every day in the morning, ברוך אלוקנו שבראנו לכבודו. Every day in the morning you say, I thank you, God, that you created me with your honor. What means? What means with your honor? What is the honor? I say, I give an example. A father in America has his son, one son in America, in New York, and they have two sons in Israel. He married off his son in America. The sons in Israel, one is rich in shekels, he lives in Tel Aviv, and one is a poor, lives in Migdal HaEmek. He sent a letter to his son in Tel Aviv, the rich man, your brother became the wedding will be in Waldorf Astoria in New York, the biggest hotel, come to the wedding, take your children, take your brother from Migdal HaEmek, his children, his wife, everything that you will spend for mine honor, I will give you back. Oh, this Israeli sees the father will give him back. He takes his wife, go to Tel Aviv, Dizengoff Center, to a boutique, you know, boutique, find them the nice clothing, himself put in the nice clothing for himself and children, but his brother in Migdal HaEmek only tell him, you know, this and this day, me flying to America, I have a ticket from El Al, come. But he don't go to buy for his brother's clothing. He don't take his brother's wife to the boutique. The day coming from the wedding, two families fly to America. In the airport in Kennedy, the father, the chatan, the bride, the family, they're waiting. First come up, the son from Tel Aviv, with the boutique, you know, with the whole thing. Oh, he says, oh, this is my children, this is my grandchildren, beautiful. Then come up the other brother from Migdal HaEmek, not clothing, that a father became shame. What can he do? He takes his son, brought him clothing for the chasnef. After the wedding, time is over, we need to go back. This son from Tel Aviv is waiting for the check. The father says, everything what you will pay, I will give you back. He don't hear anything. He come to his father. You know how much cost for the boutique? How much I make, take money from the overdraft in the bank? I need to give me back. The father said, you're a big boy, you will walk a little harder, or you'll pay back. He says, but you promised me. I promised you. I have the letter. Show me the letter. Okay. Everything what you will do for mine honor, I will give you back. If you will do for mine honor, you will take care of your brother, you will take care of his wife, you will take care of his children. What you spend for your honor, I never tell you that I will give you back for your honor. This is Baruch Elokeinu. When you want to be close to Hashem, only when you show God that you're doing for his honor, when you're caring for your brother, when you're caring for others, not only for yourself, that you will have a good life and good people and children and everything. This is the philosophy from Judaism. This is what Rabbi Akiva says, Vo'afto l'reach ha'kamocha, love your brother like you love yourself, is the most part from Torah. Ze klal gadol ba'Torah. And this is the work. After 5 years walking in the streets, in the bars, in the jails, many times I sit with crime people, very hard crime, but when you say to them face to face, he says he's a good man, he has seichel, he has a feeling, and you think, I come, that this man is a criminal. But when you look in, you see the problem. What was? He grew up in a broken home, he never received love, he never received education, and he grew up in an atmosphere from crime. If you will take him at the right time, when he's 10, 11, you give him love, education, feeling, he will be the best boy. I make one time a Hanukkah party in jail, in the beginning. I left the jail and I give a kiss one from the prisoners. Spontaneous. 2 days later, I receive a postcard. It says, Rabbi, Ivan, the prisoner, that you give him a kiss, I sit in my soul and I cry and I write you the letter. I want that you know that is the fourth time in my life that somebody gives me a kiss. I understand this is the problem. Then I decided I must do standard with the children when they're holy, before they go to jail, before they go to crime, before they go to drugs. And in 1973, I started Migdal O institution with 18 boys. In Baruch Hashem, today we have more from 6,000 children, we have more from 20,000 graduate. 900 people working together. We have also a program for 8,000 boys and girls all over Israel, 160 branches every night. And these boys used to go to the street, take drugs, fighting. They coming, they make homework, they play, they do everything. Then they have connection with the army, we go together. And this is the answer. The answer is, to give you an example, last week was a bar mitzvah, one from the boys. We make every boy bar mitzvah. 2 weeks before the bar mitzvah, this boy running after me, every time that I've been in school, Rabbi, promise me, what is want? You will not believe what a boy from the bar mitzvah asked the rabbi maybe 10 times for the bar mitzvah. What he want? To be sure that his father don't come to the bar mitzvah. Because his father is beaten and is afraid maybe he will come to the bar mitzvah. This is children, they go through, girls and boys, thousands of kids, not to believe in Eretz Yisrael. And Baruch Hashem, the idea that you need to love your brother like you love yourself, this is teaching everybody that walk together, because this is Judaism, this is the most important that can be. I see in my life that every Jew has a neshome. I don't believe the religious, not religious, Sephardim, Ashkenazim. Every Jew, I can tell you stories. This is not to believe, but I see they change from one day to the other day. One time, I sit at home. Somebody knocks in the door, and it's, I open the door in the morning, he say, I've been captured. What means you've been captured? He says, I live in Hulon, near Tel Aviv. I take a loan for money, I need money. I take a loan with big interest. I need to pay 50,000 every month, I have not. 2 guys, the underworld, come in the middle of the night, they take me from the home, take the telephones, take them to the beach in Tel Aviv, they take a gun and they say, if you don't pay, we will kill you. He sees that he's going to be killed. He don't know me, but it may be from television, from them. He says, Rav Grossman in Migdal HaEmek is my uncle. Take me to him, he will give you the money. They put him in from the beach in the car, and they brought him to me. When I see this, I go out, and I ask him, come in. You need money? Okay, I need to go to the bank to brought you money. But I have mine guys, there was also big shots like El Capone, like Pinchas. I have many, many. I decided I will teach him something. I go, I collect 15 mine guys, and I come back with mine Hasidim. And they come, I come home, and they look mine Hasidim. And mine Hasidim tell him, I will also a thief, I will also a gangster. If you will have the cheretz for the rabbi, okay. If not, we put it in a sack, we put it in a village, in our village. The old day, they speaking, the end, this man from Holon has a car. They give, he signed his car, he give him the car, finish the case, and these 2 guys leave. A day after, I have a wedding for my brother in Bnei Brak. In the middle of the wedding, the 2 guys come, a new story. The 2 gangs, what are you looking? We need to speak to you. Rabbi, me working for the big ones from the hunter world. They sit in hotels in Tel Aviv, they make the money, and me working for them, the dirty job. Yesterday, when we were in home, and we see you guys, they changed themselves. They started to learn Torah, they changed. Me want also to come to make tshuva. Take us out from the job that we're working, the bad job, the dirty job. And these two guys changed themselves and they became beautiful families. Yesterday is ready to kill somebody. And right now, he changed himself. This is the job that we need to do. My brothers and sisters, the time is very holy time. We come close to the Geula. Only 70 years was the Holocaust. In the Holocaust, Hitler and Yimach Shemo, don't ask if you're religious, not really. Every Jew in that he need to kill. And the opposite must to be, if we want to do that, every Jew to be important for us. Because if we want to have miracles, we need to walk to see. And I want to share with you something. A mayor, not religious, from the Galilee, the name is Moti Dotan, near Tiberia, called me and he says, Rabbi, I need to speak to you. Orgy, I met him, he says, I was yesterday come back from Germany. I take a delegation from 10 mayors to Germany. Because I've been the head from the delegation, they give me the honor to speak in Germany in the parliament. I finish speaking in the parliament. One from the members from the parliament from Germany comes over to me and says, I need to speak to you. He takes me on the side. He said to me, my father passed away a couple months ago. And before he passed away, my father, he told me the secret life that he was a big, big officer in the army from Hitler. He was a Nazi. And he was a big officer in the Luftwaffe with the planes. And one from the job that he became to destroy the Jewish synagogues. And he decided, I want to know what is a synagogue. He's going secret synagogue. He says to his son, and I see that the Jewish people have a holy place there, the Torah, you know, the heart. He goes over, open up, and he touched the Torah, and he sees that it's parchment. The Torah is parchment. Oh, the parchment is good for me. I can make the parchment a cover of my certificate from the army. He has a certificate from the army. He thinks, I will take this parchment and make it for a cover. He take the Torah, open the Torah, take his certificate, put in off the Torah, cut up like a Nazi, you know, the Germany exactly, and make his for a cover for his certificate. And he has us in his pocket for 60 years. Before he passed away, he says to his son is a member in the parliament in Germany, take us and see that this will come to Israel, to holy men. This parliament member sees the mayor, is the head from the delegation from Israel. He says, I want to keep up the promise to my father. Take us. I want to show you something. This is the certificate from the Nazi. See, this is the man. This is a certificate from the Nazi. Here you have the old stamps, the old fly. This is the part from the Torah they take up. They take up the part from the Torah, put in like this, make us like this for a cover, and have us in his pocket for 60 years. When I receive this, I want to see what part they take out from the Torah. In the Torah, you have 600,000 letters. But greater the world, go out from Egypt, the old mitzvot, 630 mitzvot. One part is a prophecy that will be a Holocaust. In the end, we will come back to Eretz Israel. In the end, God says, be careful. Do everything, we will not come back. And this is the part that they pick up. Can you believe a Nazi? He don't know Hebrew. He will can cut up by Shabbat, by Pesavel, by Ma. He cut up exactly the process, what you can nevuah. How do you say nevuah in English? Prophecy. He take up this prophecy only a part from 6,000 letters. Can somebody explain me? This mayor is not religious. He says, from this story, I see that the Torah is MS, but this can be regular. When I receive this, I say to myself, why God sent this paper, this story to Rav Grossman? Maybe my job is to go and speak to people and tell them what the Talmud says. If you will be united, if you will be together, if you will love the brother, if you be caring, God says, I will take care of you. This is my mission. If you keep hope, please become more spiritual. The whole idea, the beautiful idea from this Sinai organized at Mizihil, this conference that the Chief Rabbi, I want to give him again, Yashar Koach Gadol, come together, people, by me. With your permission, I will make a brocha. Baruch ata Adonino Eloheinu melech haolam shehakol niya bidvaro. L'chaim. Why I make a brocha? God became bigger if I make a brocha? He became less? No. You receive something. You have a body. You're healthy. You have water. Say thankful. The idea from brocha is say thank you. Why when you go to visit with somebody and you eat in his home, you understand when you leave, you'd say, you need to say thankful. Why you not thankful for God? This is the idea of blessing. I have not to do only with religious. Thankful. You have life. You receive to eat. I want to include with you a special story that happened to me. 6 years ago was the Lebanon war in Israel. The Lebanon war, they attacked Israel, the whole Galilee, the Hezbollah. Then the government decided to fight. I receive a telephone call from somebody in Jerusalem. The name is Yossi Paloch. I don't know him before. He says, my son is a paratroop. I go to visit my son in the base from the army, Sirkin, near Tel Aviv. I find 700 paratroops in a hangar. You know what means a hangar? The two things, the four tanks, a hangar. What happened? They be called, the old 700 paratroops, to fight. But the government don't decide to fight. Olmert was then their prime minister. Instead to be only one day to organize there, they stuck in this hangar for 10 days. You can make a shower, you can sleep, you can eat. This father says to me, Rabbi, they will lose their motivation. They need every minute to go to fight. What can we do? I say what we can do. I want everybody, the all 700 parachutes, to come to my place, to Migdal HaEmek. I will take one building from the children, take out the children, and will give McFrey for them. 6 hours later, arrived to Migdal HaEmek, the 700 parachutes. You know, in the beginning, going, somebody sent a himmel to somebody, say, oh, we're going to a rabbi, who knows, he will take us, he will put us in the synagogue, he'll make balshuva. They come, they go out from the buses. I have in the campus a swimming pool. Right away when they go out, I stay there, I say, guys, first thing to the swimming pool. Oh, thank God, they don't send us to the synagogue. They sent us to the swimming pool, Baruch Hashem, Baruch Hashem. They go to the swimming pool. After 10 days, anger, the swimming pool is a machaye, brought them clothing. They go in the dormitory. Dormitory is beautiful, like a hotel. In the night, I make them a barbecue party with Hasidish music. They dancing the old nerves that they have the 10 days, they put in dancing, you know. In middle of the dancing, some from the officers receive a telephone call from his uncle and friends. The uncle and friends said to himself, I will try to call him, I know there's a wall. Maybe he will open up, I will hear shooting. He start to hear shooting, he hears music. He says, you crazy in Israel, you're going to in the war with music? He says, no, Rav Grossman, take us, tell him the story. This man says, give me the rabbi. I take the phone. He says, Rabbi, my name is Alan Green. I live in France. I buy a new Sefer Torah in Jerusalem. I pay $40,000 for my synagogue in France. I've been so excited what you're doing with the soldiers. I decided right away, I don't take the Torah to France. I give us a gift for your school. I take the ball. I take the microphone like this, say, guys, look what a gift I receive in your honor. I receive whatever I receive a Torah. They started to sing more. I call the Sofer, the writing from the Torah in Jerusalem, please, 7 o'clock in the morning, brought the Torah to us. 7 o'clock he arrived with the Torah. The Torah is just finished, only we need to finish the last part. I go in the dining room, the whole 700 paratroops eating. Guys, your gift that I receive in your honor is here, the Torah is here. Big thing to have a letter in the Torah because every Jew is connected. If you want, you can have this zechut, go over to the Sofer and have a letter in the Torah. 700 paratroops, mostly not religious, cuckoos, earrings, everything. Everybody stays in the line, he want to have a letter in the Torah. You see every Jew as a part, as an ishomer. In the evening, I come, I brought them shekels. The children in the school make me shekels and nylons. I explain, everybody from you that want a shekel is like the money in Israel, take this shekel, keep us. After the war, you will give us a pool man. That means that all time they're in the war, you have a mission to come back. Everybody wants the shekel. Lawyers, doctors, they have many. 3 days later, they receive an order, they need to go in Lebanon. Flying the paratroops in Lebanon, fighting from inside. They became very nervous, you know. They put in the missiles, they have missiles of them, everything, and they go into the buses, to go to Lebanon. Before they go to the buses, I became very emotional. I speak to them and I say, you guys, you show God that you believe in God. You have a letter in the Torah. You have a mission to give tzedakah for the poor people. You're going to give your life for Am Israel, for Medinat Israel. You're ready to kill yourself. I promise you that everybody from you will come back safely. Nobody will be killed and nobody will win them. If you ask me, I can palm 700 guys like this, I don't know. In this minute, I was emotional. They go to the wall. 10 days later, I receive a telephone call, 12 o'clock in the night. Gadi, the head from this group, from the army, says, Rabbi, your blessing come true. Many miracles happen. Many miracles happen. And he says, me have a palmes, because I say to him, when I speak to him, I say, I need from you one palmes. That if my blessing come true, after the war, everybody comes back here to me. You don't go to your parents, to your wife, to your children. You come back here, and here we will thank God, and from here you're going. This officer says to me, Rabbi, 12 o'clock in the night, the old guys sit in the buses by the border from Lebanon, and we will be by you 2:30 in the morning. I call in the kitchen to ask for food. I call for music. Music from weddings, can you be 2:30 in Migdal HaEmek? It says, 2:30, who is going to dance? Mashiach is coming. I say, come, you will see. I pay him, 2:30 they arrived in the moon and start to go to the dormitory, make a shower. After 10 days walking, they come to me, they kiss me, 1,400 kisses this night. One stay up and says, Rabbi, I need to tell you what happened to me. I've been not a religious, a true story, he said to me. I, in a group, became a mission in Lebanon in one from the villages, and some soldier make a mistake and put in a flashlight. And this Hezbollah find that I'll be there. They sent a missile to us, and suddenly two horses arrived, two horses. They jump against the missile, they push the missile away, and they were safe. So much, I never think that the government, the army, takes everything in tapes. Two years ago, the television in Israel called me and say they have everything what I tell you, they have in tape, the army coming to Migdal HaEmek, my blessing. I say to him, give me. I would like that you will see this. I have to see right now. I arranged, they will see this part, please.
במלחמת לבנון השנייה, באמצע מלחמה, אני מקבל טלפון מיהודי שקוראים לו יוסי פלוך מירושלים. מספר לי שהבן שלו הוא צנחן. הלך לבקר את הבן שלו בסירקין בפתח תקווה, מחנה צבאי, ומצא שם קרוב ל-700 צנחנים באנגר, אנגר של טנקים. הם היו אמורים להיות שם יום-יומיים, להתארגן לקראת המלחמה, היציאה שלהם ללבנון. בגלל הבלגן שהיה בממשלה, שהחליטו לא, כן עולים, לא עולים, נתקעו שם כ-10 ימים. 10 ימים מאות צנחנים באנגר, בלי אפשרות להתרחץ נורמלי, לישון, להחליף בגדים. אומר לי האבא הזה מירושלים, הרב גרוסמן, מה עושים? צריכים לתת להם מוטיבציה, צריכים לראות מה... אמרתי לו, מה עושים? אני מזמין את כולם למגדלות. אני עומד, יש לידינו בריכת שחייה, ליד קריית הבנות. חבר'ה, כולכם לבריכה. תסתכלו, מי זה הרב הזה? במקום להגיד תפילת מנחה, הוא מתאמן על הבריכה. חבר'ה, קיבוצניקים, מושבניקים, קוקורים, כל הסוגים. עמך ישראל. ערב עשיתי להם מסיבה על האש, עם תזמורת חסידית. רקדו, נשאו.
תבינו שבמקביל התחלנו לפני 17 יום עם 900 ילדים שהוצאנו מקו הגבול והוצאנו אותם מאלמה ומאביבים ומנעריה ומאקו. רצינו בהתחלה להביא אותם לפה, אבל כשהקטיושות הגיעו לפה אז שכרנו מקומות במרכז הארץ, אז התחיל ב4 מקומות, וזה היום כבר מעל, זה קרוב ל-7,200 ילדים ב-18 מקומות.
ואתם בעזרת השם תהיו שמחים, ואתם תהיו בריאים, ואנחנו עכשיו משפחה אחת, ואתם תזמינו אותי בעזרת השם לבר מצוות של הילדים ולחתונות שלכם ולשמחות, ותמיד תזכרו את מגדל אור, את מגדל העמק. בשבילי זה זכות הכי גדולה שאני יכול לתת לכם טיפת הנאה. אני מוכן לתת את כל כולי בשבילכם. אמרת היום למפקד,
מה שצריכים, איזה ציוד, מה שצריכים, אני מוכן, כי אני מאמין
ש... יש לנו רשימה.
אמרתי למפקד, אומר לך. מחר יפגוש אותי ויש רשימה, ובלי נדר אני אשלים את הרשימה הזאת. ולכן אתם צריכים להאמין בדרככם ולהיות חזקים, והעיקר להאמין בקדוש ברוך הוא, לפתוח בשם. שמע ישראל, השם אלוקנו, השם אחד. אני מברך אתכם, אני הקטן מברך אתכם בכל לב, שהקדוש ברוך הוא ישמור אתכם ויציל אתכם מכל צרה ומצוקה ומכל נגע ומחלה, וישלח ברכה והצלחה בכל מעשה ידיכם, ידבר שונאיכם תחתיכם, ויתרכם בכתר ישועה ובתרץ ניצחון, ויקוים בנו הכתוב שהקדוש ברוך הוא השם ילחם לכם, ובעזרת השם ננצח בגדול. תהיו בריאים ונמשיך בשמחה. צרפת, אלן גרין, יהודי, והוא אומר לו, מה הרעש הזה? אז הוא אומר לו, אנחנו פה חיילים, הגיעו. אז הוא אומר, ככה, כך הוא אמר לי עכשיו, שהוא שולח מחר לכאן ספר תורה חדש שכותבים אותו, ואנחנו נכתוב אות בשביל כל אחד ואחד מכם, ואת הספר תורה הזה הוא תורם למוסד כאן לילדים. אז תראו כבר מה הרווחנו. זה עכשיו אמר לי אבי. אז תראו איך שמתגלגל, יהיה כבר כאן ספר תורה, ויזכרו אתכם תמיד בשמחות, והספר תורה תשמור עליכם, ותמשיכו בשמחה, תמשיכו.
בשמחת תורה, ותנו כבוד לתורה. שישו ושמחו, בשמחת תורה, ותנו כבוד לתורה.
לא צריך לתפוך פעז יד אחד, ואז היד שם מגבלת. הוא תופס את המדפס, ואז הוא עושה את זה. גם כבוד הרב תרמנו את זה. אנחנו כמילואיניקים, כרגע כבוד הרב סופר אותנו למרות זה. אתה מחיה אותנו. בזכותך, בגלל שהתיעוד הזה של בת העם יחסוך המון חיי אדם. אין צל של ספק. אין צל של ספק.
שמעת לך, בעזרת השם בריאים ושלמים, תתנו את זה לצדקה.
אמן.
עכשיו אתה שליח מצווה, שליחי מצווה אינם לצדקה.
זה מדבר.
יברך לך השם וישמרך יואל השם פרונו וילך
שלמים, כולכם תחזרו בריאים ושלמים, ונשמע ממכם הרבה בשורות טובות.
אחרי 10 ימים אני מקבל טלפון מיוני המפקד, המגד, הרב, הברכה שלך התקיימה. אנחנו כולנו יושבים עכשיו בשטולה באוטובוסים, כולם בריאים ושלמים, לא יכולים לזוז. עשינו נדע שחוזרים אליך לפני הכל. ב2:30 בלילה אנחנו נהיה אצלך. יארתי את החבר'ה במטבח, חבר'ה להכין ארוחת ערב, התחלתי לחפש תזמורת, מצלצלת תזמורת, אולי אתם יכולים להיות ב2:30 במגדל העמק, מה קרה? משיח הגיע. ב2:30 בלילה הם הגיעו, יורדים מהאוטובוסים, כל אחד ניגש אליי, יותר משעתיים עמדתי לנשק אותם ולחבק אותם, לנשק, אני לא יכול לתאר את ההתרגשות, לא הייתי בעולם הזה. הוא אומר, הרב, אני חייב לספר לך, מיד עכשיו, היינו קבוצת חיילים, קיבלנו משימה באחד הכפרים בלבנון לעשות.
הלכנו לחפש מקום להיות שם בלילה, ביום למחרת יותר נכון, והראו עליהם טיל ברחוק. היו שני סוסים שעמדו 4 מטר מהחיילים, הטיל פגע 10 מטר, היו שני סוסים שעמדו 4 מטר, והם מפגעים. אני בן אדם, אני לא דרגעי. אבל מישהו
שם שם פסוס. כל מה שקורה, בזכות הרב. הרב נתן לנו ברכה ביציאה, הזיג לנו אצבעות, כל יום היה מתקשר עליי לשאול מה שלומם. חזרנו בריאים ושלמים, בזכות הרב.
כולם, שקיינו וקיימנו.
אני מהרגע שעזבתם, לא היה לי מנוחה דקה. קמתי לפנות בוקר, התפללתי, הדלקתי לרוב, הלכתי לקברי צדיקים, ביקשתי מהקדוש ברוך הוא שאני אזכה לראות את כולכם חוזרים בריאים ושלמים שאף אחד לא ייפצע. והנה שחיינו וקיימנו והגיענו לזמן הזה. אבל אתם בליבי לתמיד, ובעזרת השם נתראה מתוך שמחה.
תודה רבה. Let's take this power that you have here coming, hearing Torah, spiritual, take us home. Everybody from you need to think, I will be ambassador. I will do for my neighbor, I will do for everybody. Be'ezrat Hashem, we will come close to Judaism, we will be together, and soon we'll see you everybody in Yerushalayim, Mir HaKodesh. Amen ve Amen.
All English lectures are available online at hebrew.com.